Hello! This video is a complete guide which covers how to contribute to Godot using Gitkraken. We will go through forking, cloning, building, committing, rebasing, submitting pull requests, and more. Remember that you don't have to be able to write C++ to contribute. You can always contribute documentation, and you can always test other people's pull requests as well. You can follow this tutorial from Windows, Mac, or Linux, but I will be using Linux in this guide. I am assuming that you already have a GitHub account. If not, you can go ahead and create one now. And the first thing you'll want to do is fork the repository. You can do that by clicking this button here that says fork. And if you get a screen like this, just click on your name. And you'll get a little picture of a book with a fork in it. Very, very funny. And this essentially gives you a copy of Godot that's stored on GitHub. And you'll be able to download this and then push to it later. Once you have forked Godot, you will never have to do this step again. Next, we will download and install the tools that we need. Gitkraken is a very nice graphical Git client and is what we will be using for most of the video. Simply click here where it says free download and choose the appropriate file. Once you have Gitkraken downloaded, you can go ahead and open it. And once it opens, you will get a screen that looks something like this. Feel free to click sign in with GitHub to make your life easier. Once you have signed in to Gitkraken, click the folder icon on the top left of the screen, then click clone and GitHub. You'll need to browse for a place to clone it to. I recommend creating a folder called Workspace in your home directory. Once you've done that, click on Godot, and then click Clone the Repo. This may take a few seconds, or a minute, and then once it's done, you will have a copy of Godot stored on your computer. Once it's finished cloning, click Open Now. Now that we've cloned the repository, let me explain what you're seeing on your screen right now. In the middle, you have all of the commits that have been made. At the top left, right here, where it says master, this is the branch that's currently checked out because it has a check mark, and it is stored on your computer, indicated by this computer icon here. This is local. And you can also see here it says origin, and that is the remote that it is on as well. If you look here for the remote section, you have origin, which is going to be your copy of the repository stored on GitHub. And then we're also going to need to add a few other remotes. Hover over the word remote and click the plus. Then, where it says GitHub repo, click on Godot engine / Godot. You can type the name as upstream, just to make things simple. Once you've added a remote for Godot, you'll see their branches here under the word upstream, and you will also see all the commits and branches in the middle here, merged with your own. So we have the master branch here with the Godot logo next to it, and then this one here. This one is stored on your remote on GitHub. Very often you'll find that there are new commits added to a repo after you've forked it. So what you can do to update it is take this master here, which is your local version, and drag it onto the remote's updated version. Click the word rebase. Now your version is updated. You'll also see this 4 with an up arrow here, 4 ahead. So to push these changes back to your copy of the repo stored on GitHub, simply push the push button. Now that we've set up Gitkraken and cloned Godot, we'll need to set up our build environment. You'll basically need Python, Scons, and a handful of C++ libraries. If you're on Windows, you can install them by getting Visual Studio. Make sure you get C++ support installed with it. If you're on Mac, it's similar instructions, but with Xcode. And if you're on Linux, simply use one of these commands to install dependencies depending on your distro. If you're on Linux, I've also created some small build scripts linked in the description that help make sure that you have all the dependencies required and build Godot for you. All you have to do, once you put it in your local bin, is type build Godot in a terminal and it will start building. Don't worry if it's taking a while to compile. In the future, it'll take less time as it does not need to recompile everything every time. It will only need to compile the changes that you've made. Once Godot finishes building, you should get something that looks like this. If Godot opens, it means that it has been built successfully. Now that we're able to build Godot, we can start making changes or testing other people's changes. For now, let's start by testing other people's changes. We can close this and minimize this because we won't be needing it for now. Go back to the GitHub website. Note how there's a difference between your fork and the original. So click back to the original by clicking this link here. Then you can hit pull requests to see other people's pull requests. To test this pull request, what we'll basically need to do is download the code from this branch on their fork. You can click right here to open up their fork, then go up to the URL bar. We don't need the tree or anything after it, so copy the first part, and then go into Gitkraken. Go over remote and hit the plus, this time go to URL. Paste in the URL here, and set the name to the name of the fork that you're cloning. Then click add remote. As you can see, he has a lot of branches. We only want this particular one here. So, make note of that, go back into here, and I can see it right here. Double click on the branch to check it out. Since we checked out the branch, all of its changes are now live on our computer. If you select any commit, on the right here you can see which files have been changed. You can also click on it to see in depth what has been added and removed. Obviously green means that something has been added and red means that something has been removed. To go back, click on the X. Now, if we'd like to test the changes, we can simply open up a terminal again and rerun the build command. As you can see, it's going much faster than last time because it only needs to recompile a few different files. Once Godot finishes compiling, you can go ahead and test whatever changes you'd like to test. If all you wanted to do is test out somebody else's pull request, you're done and you can stop watching the video. However, if you'd like to make some changes to Godot and contribute them back, keep watching. Now, let's say that we wanted to start making some changes to Godot and contribute them back. The first thing that we're going to want to do is switch back to the master branch. Then, right-click the commit that the master branch is on, and hit Create Branch here. Call it whatever you want. We'll call it Awesome Feature. Try to be descriptive in your branch names. Now that we've created a branch, we can go ahead and open up the Godot folder and make whatever changes we'd like to make. For an example, I'm just going to add a little bit of text to README. Right here, I think I'll write, Godot is awesome. Make sure to press Ctrl+S to save. Now, if we go back to Gitkraken, you can see here that there's been a change. If I click on README, it says, Godot is awesome. Now, I have a few options here. You can hit Stage All Changes, and this will basically save all of your changes. You can stage just the file, or just a piece of the file if you'd like. So let's go ahead and stage the changes. We have to give a name to our commit. So I'll just call it Godot is awesome, and then hit commit, and then it shows up in the tree as a commit. Once you've done this, hit the push button. It'll ask where you want to push it and pull it from. Go ahead and just leave this blank and hit submit. Once you've pushed, next to the branch name, you will have this icon here. It says origin, and it'll be your GitHub profile picture, and this basically means that the code is stored on GitHub servers now. Now let's go ahead and remove this, and as you can see here, the branch is now stored on Origin. Now that the commit has been pushed to GitHub, go ahead and go back to your web browser. Refresh the page if you need to. It'll show up here as a new branch that you recently pushed, and you have the option here to compare and pull requests. You can see this notification either from your fork or the upstream Godot. All you need to do now is hit compare and pull request, give your pull request a nice title and description, and then hit create pull request. If you're creating something that's work in progress, you also have the option of creating a draft pull request right here. Now, as you may have guessed, things aren't always quite that simple. Over time, pull requests will be merged and changes will be made to the Godot repo. You will frequently have to perform what's called a rebase. To do this, simply check out the branch that you want to rebase by double-clicking on it, then click and drag, either from here or from the side here, on top of the latest master. Then click Rebase. Do not click Merge, click Rebase. Once you do this, your changes will be placed on top of the latest master. This is the state you want to be in. It should look like this. If you hover over the 99 plus here, it tells you that I am 581 commits ahead of the previous time I pushed this branch. So what I'm going to do is hit Push, and it comes up with this message here. But what I'm going to do is just hit the force push button, which is in red. Anytime you rebase and push, you have to do the force push. Once you do that, the change will now be live on GitHub. And if I open Firefox, I can see that the automated build system has started building. Anytime you push a change to a pull request or open a new pull request, Godot's automatic tools, Atfayer and Travis, will build your pull request automatically. This is an easy way that the Godot team can check if your pull request builds fine or if it has any problems. If building fails for whatever reason, you'll need to make changes and then force push again. If you need to make a change on one of your pull requests, go ahead and make the change while you have the branch checked out. It'll look like this. and you'll have these unstaged files here. And we can stage these. And we have a couple options here. We can create a commit like normal. But the problem with that is that now there are two commits, and we don't really want that. We only want one. Or we want a small amount. We generally want each commit to reflect a certain change. You can control click both of them and then hit squash. And if you squash, click on the top right here where you have the name and description of the commit. Then click on it and scroll down to the bottom and erase this text here, because we probably don't want stuff like that. Alternatively, what we can do is hit the undo button right here. This will take the repo back into the previous state it was before you did the action. Now, instead of writing a message here and committing, what we can do is check the box here that says amend. Then when you click this, it will automatically take your changes and put them into one commit. Once you've made the change, you simply need to force push. If at any time you make a mistake or you want to go back in time, and the undo button will not do what you want it to do, you can right-click any commit and hit reset to this commit, and then click hard. This will completely revert your branch to that commit. If both you and somebody else have changed the same piece of code since you made your pull request, what you'll need to do is rebase, but you will run into a conflict. And these conflicts have to be resolved manually. When you run into a conflict, it will look like this. A file conflict was found when attempting to merge into head. Click on this yellow message here, and on the right it tells you that there are some conflicted files. So just looking at this here, I don't have exactly enough context to tell what is going on here. So what I'm going to do is actually note the file here, gdmonomarshall.cpp, and I'm going to go into Firefox, into github.com, and browse to the file. Once I found the file that I'm looking for, I can look on the right and see the last change that's been made to it. Once you've opened up the commit on github.com, go ahead and Control F to find the file you want, and I can see all the changes that have been made to this file in this commit. If I scroll down, I can see that all that was added here was a blank line. So back in Gitkraken, I'm actually going to check the box here next to B, which is resolving in favor of my local copy. But I'm going to go down to the bottom here and make sure that the new line is still there. Once you're finished with resolving conflicts, click the Save button at the top right. Then you hit the button that says Continue Rebase at the bottom. When you have conflicts, they will show up like this on github.com. But once you've resolved the conflicts, you can click Push and then Force Push. Once the changes have been pushed, the message of a conflict will go away, and the build systems will start building your pull request. I highly recommend that you take the time to master all the previous steps that we've covered. However, I'll cover a few more advanced things in this video. If at any time you'd like to remove all generated files and recompile everything from scratch, all you need to do is open up a terminal and run the command git clean -f capital X D. This will remove all generated files and recompile everything from scratch the next time you run build Godot. You may have noticed that all of my commits have the word verified next to them, and if I click on it, it says this commit was signed with a verified signature. This is done using GPG, and while I won't go into exactly how to set up a GPG key for yourself, I will show you how to integrate it into Gitkraken and GitHub. If you have GPG installed and a key imported, all you need to do is open the preferences in Gitkraken, go down to GPG preferences, and select your key from the drop-down menu. Once you've imported the key into Gitkraken, you can import the GPG key into your account on GitHub. This way, all of your commits will show up as verified. This step is not at all necessary, but it can help with security. So, if you feel like it, you may as well do it. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it and you found it helpful, please share it with people. If you're not already a contributor, I hope this video helped you become one. If you're already a contributor, I hope this video helped you improve yourself. Godot is awesome, and Gitkraken is an awesome tool, and the more people using awesome tools and contributing, the better.